All right, today is the day. I've postponed this long enough. I can't hold it off anymore. Still 79 degrees for the high today, and overnight we're getting just about 50 degrees, 50, 52, 55. But these petunias got to be dug up and put away for the winter. So let's get going. Last year, if you remember, this guy here, I had him in the ground and overwintered him in my greenhouse. And this year, we're gonna dig him up and do the same thing in those mums right there. I need this pot right here, put those mums in. So I gotta dig this up, get rid of that petunia, put it in the greenhouse, overwinter it. And then this guy right here too is Priscilla. That one I'm gonna dig up and put it in the greenhouse. All right. Show you what we have here. You can see it's just one petunia, and the reason that the stem is so big is because it's from last year. They do get big over time. That's the great thing about these things. I mean, if you have you don't need a greenhouse. I know I said everybody should go get a greenhouse, but, you know, realistically, if you don't have room for a greenhouse, or you don't have the money to go and buy a greenhouse, you can put it in shed. In fact, I'll show you what you can do. I have a shed, and we'll take this guy, and we will pot him up, and we will put him in the shed. I'll leave him there all winter. Shed doesn't freeze. I have a tiny little heater in there. I usually reserve that room, that shed area, because it's not that much room. But I like to take my cuttings in the winter time and get them going. And there's not that much room, so I like to reserve that room for my cuttings. But I will take this plant right here, this super tunia bubblegum, and I will put it in the greenhouse, or not the greenhouse, but the shed, the pump house. This thing is filled with roots. Look at the root growth on that thing. There you go. Look at this. Look at that mat. Let me show you what kind of medium I have in here. This is just peat moss, perlite, and there's about 50% sand, 50% peat moss perlite. So it's pretty loose, well-draining stuff. Here's some more potting mix here. That's a little better. Find the base. kind of got mixed up in my Mondo grass here. I'm gonna get rid of this one. It's too leggy. Running all over the place. Get rid of the weed debris. I don't want to carry that with me. And when you're digging stuff up and putting it away, especially in your greenhouse or shed or something, you want to make sure that you don't carry pests like a mole or slug. Not a mole, I mean a slug. A mole. You're gonna carry a mole with you. That's funny. Now you can see there's a 1.5 gallon pot. I just kind of stuffed it in here. Put some dirt on. It doesn't much matter. We're just gonna stick it in a dry, warm place. Alright, let's go put these where they're gonna sit. There's another one I gotta dig up. More in here. I don't really need that many. Okay. So here is my pump house. It's about 65 degrees in here. No heat. I have some greenhouse lights up here. You don't really need those greenhouse lights. This is just a white LED light. Right now I have some sunflower seeds that are drying out. Plant for next year. Because it's nice and dry in here. But yeah, this is just my area. It's all you need. Someplace dry, warm, that you can keep your stuff. These will get moved off. I have a hot mat here for when I propagate my cuttings. And then I have another area down here for when the cuttings get a little bigger. This needs to go somewhere else. Down underneath where there are no lights. Yeah. And that's it. That's my storage area. Just some lights. I get these at Walmart. And that's it. Store my stuff here for the winter. My hanging baskets will just be left up in here. As long as I keep this fan running. Last year we got down to 12 degrees. 8 degrees outside, 12 degrees in here. Fan was running, and I didn't buy any of these petunias. They came from last year. They all came from last year. So, yeah, overwinter them. Overwinter your petunias. You know, it's gonna save you a lot of money. Start in about March, take cuttings off the new growth. When they start to put on new growth, cut them, put them in the rooting hormone, and you'll get 10, 20 brand new plants. That's what I do. That's where I get all mine. I only overwinter probably, I don't know, four or five plants, and the rest I just get from cuttings off of the last year's plants. All right, there you go. That's all I got to say about that. You got anything to add? Noisy. There you go.